In From the Depths, there are countless ways of playing the game, and one way which I always seem to ignore is the idea of having drones during combat. And this itself can be done in multiple ways, either having vehicles that your main vehicle holds, having vehicles which are spawned in straight away during combat, or having vehicles which are spawned in during the fight, like these tiny little strike craft here from the Angelic. There are loads of ways of doing this, and many more not being shown here, and it's something I never ever do. So today, we're going to be taking that to the extreme. Having a mothership which simply can't do any damage at all, that is to say, no munition defense, no regular damage, and not even ramming targets, and relying solely on drones for all of the damage. The drones in turn will take resources from the mothership, and I will make sure that we have lots of drones rather than just having a single super drone. So having a resource cap depending on the difficulty, probably about 150 at the very, very end. That is to say, 150,000. I think this is going to be lots of fun, and honestly incredibly time-consuming, but hopefully worth it. I'll also be trying to make mechs during this fight, because, well, I never make mechs either. So lots of Twin Guard-styled vehicles. So with that, let's get into the adventure mode itself. One day, I'll be able to make a concise intro. And so we begin our journey with some of the worst weather I've ever seen. So first things first, we need to build our first drone, and we need to get a little bit more stabilized, because at the moment, if I try and build in this mode, I'm going to get very seasick very, very quickly. I mean, look at the weather. That is absolutely atrocious. There we are. Basic PIDs. We're now stable. So new blueprint, new vehicle. We'll just spawn it over here and give it the basic so it doesn't instantly despawn, which can happen if you try and build something and leave it as like a single block. There we are, some batteries in the mainframe, and we have our first vehicle being held. Set to 90. Okay, so the first build is something I've done a million times before, which is going to be an absolutely tiny little plane. A tiny plane holding tiny little missiles. The reason for this is because they don't really need proper detection systems or anything else. Eventually, the mothership will be providing detection for everything, but right now, I just need a completely autonomous craft, and little missiles and a tiny plane is just the easiest way I know how to do this. Ooh, though I might actually go with the propeller this time rather than the thruster. We'll see as we build. Essentially, it's going to be an AI-controlled stick. Future designs, I swear, will be a lot more complex than just this, but you're kind of seeing the basics already. So, batteries there, tiny bit of ammo, we'll have the engine on top to control the batteries. Now, if we do add a propeller, it's going to have to go at the back because of how I'm going to be placing these missiles. So maybe for now we'll stick with a thruster. Soon enough, though, I do want a proper drone in the true drone sense. I want a small one using the propellers, and they're likely going to be holding something which requires a bit more stabilization, like a tiny advanced cannon or a tiny simple weapon. But for now, little thruster on the back. Okay, they're all staying away from each other. Lovely, all different altitudes. I'm going to pretend I didn't see that randomness there. I'll try and fix that later, though. Oh, don't like the fact this first enemy has an anti-air weapon. Yep, that's kind of the weakness of these things. One hit and they will be destroyed. Though, to be fair, they do cast less than just a normal weapon, so that's it. Keep on firing the one that's spinning out. Yeah, see, the issue is, because we have no detection at the moment, they're kind of losing their lock on the enemy, and that's what's causing these weird movements. Okay, cool. Missiles from two of them were enough to destroy the first enemy. Not the most impressive first showing, but that was like a trial run. I'll fix more stuff later. Okay, you, let's add some detection. Okay, now they can actually see a target. Yeah, they're doing pretty well with their movement. Fantastic. One more enemy destroyed, and please return to base. Lovely. Now, one thing I did notice is the reason why they're moving so slowly, and I was surprised by how slowly, is they don't have enough engine power. Yeah, we didn't fully fuel their batteries, because I didn't set them up to take power from the main craft properly. Next time, they'll be moving a lot faster, so they're pretty stable in combat. They're going to be quicker. What I need to do now is make their missiles longer range. And also actually build our Minecraft, which at the moment is a tower. Well, they're definitely faster now, so that's good. They're going to be releasing their missiles at 1,500 rather than 1,000. I think they'll have enough range, but we'll see. I gave them some extra fuel and slightly faster movement speed. Lovely. Much better being at that range. Still weak as anything, but again, bear in mind that enemies like this still cost 2 to 3 times one of these drones. These drones are pretty much nothing. They're just paper. Very angry paper. Their movements still confound me, and I still think it's something to do with drag, but at least it makes them very difficult to track, which, honestly, that's fine. If I can avoid some light anti-air fire, then that's all I really care about. Perfect. Okay. Now to build up the Minecraft, we can clearly defend ourselves versus the super easy enemies, and we'll build a new type of drone in the next difficulty. So I'll be right back once I've turned this into something. Thankfully, it's been very peaceful. Did that thing just destroy itself? Okay, interesting. I was about to say, it's been very peaceful, so I've been able to build this. However, I'm not happy with it. We are going to be changing this up again later on, probably making a true aircraft carrier, just a proper ship. But for the time being, I want to get to that resource zone. I want to be able to finish this thing off so at least I have some armor for my craft. Then we'll be going through one of the red portals. And obviously I'll be collecting that resource when I can. I also learned something which I didn't know, but it's actually common sense looking at it. If you have a low air density, in other words, if you're too high up like we are, thrust is then reduced from these propellers. Makes complete sense. Didn't even cross my mind. Also, at the moment, we're going to be dropping our planes like this. This is the main reason why I built this, and I realise they're not going to like that. It's going to be difficult to do in the future, especially since I want submarine drones and just boats and everything else. Being on the water will be better later on. Well, at least it turns out you can drop these things just fine. They have absolutely no problem being dropped into combat. It did take them a little bit longer to lock onto the target, though, I think because trying to adjust to being the correct way up again took them a bit longer, but yeah, no real problem there. Okay, gonna make this thing a boat now completely. I have completely abandoned the aircraft idea, then we're going straight through a red portal, so difficulty 5 incoming. The one good thing with the drones is that I can keep on building even while we fight. Okay, pull them back. Fantastic. That'll be the last fight now in difficulty 1. Heading towards Red Portal for difficulty 5. This might be the most bland-looking craft I've ever built. It has almost no personality, but it's gonna work just fine. It's super light. It's pretty much hollow right now, so there's loads of space for expansion. It can go at a decent speed for very, very little. And it floats because it's made of light alloy, so it needs no propellers or any power to actually keep it in the water. Which is pretty important because we're going to be feeding a lot of power to our drones. We also have enough now to build a fourth one of these, which I think I will do, and that'll be the last of these I build, and then I'll start building a new type of drone. Difficulty 5, our first enemy is lobbing some cram shells at us. The first one did actually hit and do a lot of damage. It is, aww, a cute Onyx Watchcraft. A bastion worth 34,000. Well, it's a lot of resource for us if we can kill it, and I'm assuming it doesn't have much anti-air. So hopefully our little bugs are going to have a fun time here, and I think the safest position for my craft is actually as close as possible. Well, super close would work. Never mind, I'm just going to keep on moving around randomly. Another pro is having the drones do my fighting. I don't have to focus on them at all. Just keep moving randomly left and right, changing my speed occasionally, and the crams should, for the most part, miss their mark. Okay, we're now dealing some damage. Oh, there's an aircraft. Okay, we can mostly ignore that. Let's focus on the bastion. Maybe EMP would be better, but saying that, small missiles EMP, not great. I stopped focusing for 1 second. Come on, bugs, do some more damage. There we go. Well, it took absolutely ages, but it seems like the enemy's pretty much turned off now. I've swapped two of them to EMP. I'm not sure if it's the EMP or the fragments. The fragments have now started entering the vehicle itself, so it could have been either. There's a chance we might actually be able to get a capture here, which I will take advantage of. Normally, I'd be avoiding too many captures because it's too much resource too easily, but the odds of getting captures when using drones and me not being close to the enemy is so low. This might be the one chance I can actually get that done. Maybe I'll swap them all. Yeah, the enemy's there trying to attack us, but again, our planes are just so small, it's so difficult to aim at them. I think the weapons have been completely turned off. Yeah, the local weapon controllers were destroyed really early. I really need new drone type. I'm honestly thinking just basically what we have already, just a little bit bigger, holding medium missiles, or a simple weapon, because small missiles, I forgot just how little they do. This is taking so long. Like, yeah, we did disable the target fairly quickly, but boy, have I been here for like 10 minutes. So this enemy is actually a problem. This is the Scrapper, and it's bringing flat cannons, along with, I think it may have even used some anti-missile stuff, which I did not expect. So one of our drones there in the air is currently damaged. I think it's lost its front, so that one's pretty much out for the count for the moment. But we have already damaged its flat cannon. If we can hit that again... Okay, good. The drones have taken out an anti-aircraft. Brilliant. Meanwhile, I'm building a truly bizarre drone at the moment. I have plans for this, I swear. So this is the kind of thing I want to make later on for our smaller craft. Again, the ones we have currently are just really there as a temporary measure. This is the kind of distraction vehicle we want. Love how choosing the thrusters again. I've seen that a lot now, so I definitely need to do that myself. Oh, it used them for turning, I think. Brilliant. Look at that. Just watching it is so neat. Very cool. I think we took out its weapons, though. It took out one of our drones, then I think we hit it and took out its weapon. Yeah, its bottom's been damaged. But it still has its flare, so it's just kind of a stalemate at the moment, so I guess I'll just stop and build. Took a while, but we did eventually take it out. Well, this thing isn't ready yet. In fact, it's not even positioned right on the boat, but it's time to test it out because we're currently under attack. Where is the enemy? Are we going the correct way? Why did you all go the wrong way for a second there? Did you swap targets or something? Either way, you are definitely moving the right way now. Okay. So, this much larger aircraft is still actually a very small aircraft. It's only about 12k resources, and it has much, much more powerful missiles. It only has two of them at the moment. We can upgrade it a lot later once we have some more resources. Ooh, there's a flyer as well. Odds of these hitting the flyer are pretty low. They're not exactly agile missiles. I was hoping to go straight for this thing. That looks cool. I love it when you have a load of flyers all together. I quite like how this thing's turned out. I wanted it to look quite stumpy, and I think I've achieved that while still making it look purposeful. Okay, the enemy plane is gone. Oh no, both of them are gone. Well, it helped they were attacking each other, I suppose. Let's go through the red portal and we'll start fighting things a little bit harder then, and try and make sure this plane works properly. It's hard to tell sometimes if you're not testing out in the sandbox mode, you can easily miss things. Am I bringing them back or not? Yes, I am. Okay, good. It's that red portal we're going at. Tiny little weird boat thing. Difficulty 10, I've changed up the missiles in this craft. Now they're cruise missiles, so they can survive for a full minute and have enough fuel for that full minute, which means they're going to go very, very, very far. But that also means I've had to sacrifice some of the warheads, so they're not going to hit as hard. Before they were hitting at something like 35, 40,000 damage each, now it's closer to 20,000. But they can fire straight away and more consistently, so I think that should make up for the shortcomings of the smaller drones. I think. Now to finish painting this. Actually, no, I need to do some things with the boat still. It needs some major renovations, even at this low cost. Our first enemy of difficulty 10. Okay, there it is. This thing is a particle cannon. I just had to spend 3 minutes fixing the damage it dealt to us. Okay, here's our long-range missiles, and one hit, two hits? Oh, just about missed. Yeah, that damage is so much less now. Still, it is able to hit, unlike the smaller drones, who are really struggling to stay close enough. We need some other types of weapon. Plasma, laser, our own particle cannon, just some kind of hit scan weapon to hit these quicker targets. Order some more missiles. To be fair, the bombard currently has one set of missiles. I want it to have at least six of these. So if six of those are all hitting at once, The cannon's gone, we've won. But yeah, if all six were hitting at once, it'd be a lot more devastating. Which is nice to think about. I'll just wait until this fight's over then. I can see them in the distance, they're so far away. You can just about see the smoke trails. I am at least happy with this thing's movement. If nothing else. It uses its yaw turning. If it's within 20 degrees of the gnat, it can go up to 90 degrees in a banking roll, and so far it's been able to keep track of it really well. I mean, to be fair, so these little drones, only using yaw turning, but still, this one can turn far sharper is the point. It's moving at 50 meters per second, but this thing must be really quick because it's always just out of reach. Hit those jets, please! Maybe I need my own hydrofoil craft. Something I didn't consider is when the drones are this far out, they're actually losing battery. I'm no longer feeding them. They're no longer in my range. As I add more storage to my craft, I believe that also increases the range I can feed battery power, so that shouldn't be a problem later on. Oh my god, you are so annoying. Please just get hit. Thank you. There we go. Beautiful. Is that a shrike? It's a shrike with no face. Ooh, do the missiles of the shrike now have their own style? Oh, they're barrels! Oh, I love that. Okay, need to use that as elves. Okay, the last enemy of difficulty 10. I'm about to spawn in a second bombard, and then we're moving to difficulty 15. We have a little corsair. I think he's actually trying to attack. Yep, it's using flak to attack our newest drone. Ooh, the new missiles the drone have, though, are a lot more deadly than they used to be. Yep, those are still the cruise missiles, but there's simply now six of them. Fired again. Wow, these smaller drones didn't even get in range that time. Lovely to see. How smoothly the mothership turns is honestly somewhat disconcerting. And this is at low battery power, it's just so smooth. Either way, it's time to go to difficulty 15. This will be the last of the aircraft-style drones we build for a while. The next one's likely going to be a skimmer or something like that, using plasma cannons or particle cannons or something. Just something a bit different to just missiles, missiles, and more missiles. I promise, missiles will become a lot less frequent as we continue. We also want rail guns and just loads of other options. Missiles are just such a good early option. Whoa, that is actually kind of scary to look at. Lovely. Kind of looks like a weird face from behind. Hi. Oh, you. Now that's a scary thing, despite not being all that expensive. The Curiosity has particle cannons and lasers baked into its legs. Why did it instantly hit the water? Well, I am now very confused. Oh! Hoo-hoo, that's not good for us. Okay, turn around and run. Yeah, if one of you can hit that by mistake with a missile. You know what? Everyone stop firing. No! Don't kill the thing fighting the sub! That's it, just let the thing do its work. Okay, actually killed the enemy, fantastic. Note to self, we need an anti-sub drone immediately. Thank you for saving us, that was your reward. We just got so weirdly lucky. Later, missiles get countered so much more heavily, so I'm just enjoying my favorite weapon at the moment. Okay, we have a resource zone here next to a red portal, so we're going to completely siphon this. It's going to give us 30,000 more resource, go through the red portal, and then make our next drone, which is either going to be a skimmer or a hovercraft. Potentially even a sort of twin guard style, where we have a hover base, and then a second vehicle, which is sitting on top. because I really want either plasma or particle cannon or laser or something else interesting. And probably we're gonna get rid of the little insects. They've been fun, but they are pretty useless at this point. Okay, in theory, this should almost be done now. I just need to completely armor up the bottom and the sides. So this is going to be the base, and then we can have a customizable top on this thing. So it's just very cheap armor with enough battery power to feed whatever it's holding, in addition to enough material storage, once again, to repair anything it's holding. So this is going to hold some kind of turret cap. It currently costs about 9,000, so again, the base, super cheap. Whatever's on top is going to be more expensive, and we can make different turret caps to place on top of this thing. Okay, balance is a bit off, I'm noticing that straight away, but that's something we can fix easily. A little bit of bouncing, honestly, won't be too bad. Okay, good. Now to build a quick turret cap. In today's episode of Lathrix Learns Basic Game Mechanics of a game he has put thousands of hours into, you cannot have a tractor beam on a vehicle already being affected by a tractor beam. Now, there are ways around this, but they're all going to be really irritating. Also, apparently, we're currently under attack. It was a nuke craft. A small nuke craft was trying to kill us. They're all part of the same fleet. It's been set to follow us and try to figure out our waypoints in order not to hit us. Okay, that's wonderful. Yep, that's absolutely no problem at all. Now, of course, this does mean that we're going to be using up more battery power, but still. So if I turn and go away, you should also follow me, right? Okay, it takes a second for it to kick in, but good. Is that the position I wanted you? Well, we'll figure out if there's any problems and we'll troubleshoot as we go. It's not really an issue. So I was thinking particle cannon and then particle cannon EMP for the first weapon. This is only one of two weapons which is going to go on this base. Ooh, that's a lot of stuff removed. It wasn't the mainframe death, but I think that's a lot of its weapon systems gone. So currently this thing only costs 15,000, which is actually pretty nice, the turret cap. But these are just two very small particle cannons with a 30 second reload. Then the main weapon's gonna go on its right arm. Yes, I've tried to make a mech in a rushed fashion. I'm not good at making mechs at the best of time. Nice. And this was on a time limit, but still fantastic. Brilliant first kill for our little drone. Why is it being held slightly off to the side? Oh, because the center of mass is off as I was building it, okay. Yeah, so we need to build the secondary arm as well. I think it looks alright for a stumpy little mech boy. I'm gonna call him Stump. I somehow managed to turn off the mic while building and I've just been talking to myself for the last half an hour. Anyway, so we are pretty much done with the drone now. We are now in difficulty 20 and this is how the thing looks. So the laser system is a pretty weak one. It's basically just anti-air to destabilize smaller targets, and then the EMP weapon is kind of the main weapon with the particle cannon. The whole thing costs about 35,000, so still very cheap for the ocean adventure mode. But we can, of course, upgrade that very easily. It wouldn't take much to take up one of the arms and make it bigger, or just make this back section more encompassing. There's loads we can do to make this more expensive, or just swap out the weapons very easily. Just knock off this bottom section, and then we can add a missile system. We can add missiles to the back. We can change this into a railgun. Loads of stuff we can do later. For now, it's a little base thing. First enemy of difficulty 30, and whoa, adorable little planes. Okay then. Release the swarm. It's too far away at the moment, the weapons are currently not gonna fire. Whoa, what is happening to that thing? Guess I should start moving, it's likely that's firing at me.
Engaging now.
So there's the laser doing some light damage there straight away from our new craft. And then the missile swarm. EMP hitting there, probably from our particle cannon. Oh no, it's firing at our planes. Here's hoping they can take some hits. They should be able to take a few, though they are weakest in their core. Those Those missiles are just brutal. Not really the best showing there from our particle cannon. Yeah, sure, it did some decent EMP damage, but not enough. Oh. No, I've had it set to PS. Never mind. Maybe it did do loads. It's hard to tell.
Engaging now.
Ooh, ad detection might not be the best. Yeah, maybe I need to add some to the craft itself as well. That laser is so puny compared to our other weapons. Still though, it stopped it from being able to fire already. There we go, the particle cannon finishing off. The particle cannon, of course, being the main weapon there. Lovely. Our first victory in difficulty 30. I can already see a lot of things I need to improve. Well, that was pretty cool. So I've added some sonars to the main craft, and that's allowing us to actually see underwater, and that's enough, apparently, for this thing to hit, at least at very close range. As soon as I say that, it missed, but you get the point, it can at least have a chance of hitting. So I've changed up how the EMP particle cannon works. It now fires every 10 seconds. It does a little bit less damage and costs more since it's overclocked, but hopefully that'll make it more reliable. A lot of vital components already gone from this thing. Not its AI, though, sadly. It's still moving. I wonder what those parts even did. Ooh, I wonder if I had a weapon beforehand, because it doesn't seem to be firing now. Oh, looks like it's not quite sure what to do anymore. It's now trying to become a flying fish. Or is it meant to do that when it gets close? That'd be an interesting thing to do. Okay, a victory one-on-one with our new vehicle. Perfect. And with that, we go to difficulty 25. Welcome to difficulty 25. Is that just Steamworks? I think it is. No, it's a smog. It's a much scarier version. Oh, that's really cool. Never mind. It's not at all what I thought it was. Did that just explode itself? Because that was one of our missiles. I'm assuming the EMP messed up something. So many EMP hits. I'm hoping that took out some of the weapons. It's a bit hard to tell when they have so many. Okay, it's aiming one of our planes, which I think is actually taking the hits pretty well so far. I've also added some detection systems onto our new drones themselves. Ooh, is it using a cram cannon as... Or is that advanced cannon as, counter missiles? I think so. What a cool design the smog is. So many weapons. It is essentially a flying weapons platform. And I kind of want to steal this as the idea for our main vehicle eventually. Just about the weapons. Suddenly wishing we weren't using EMP, but instead using piercing damage so we can actually put some more damage through. Still, that EMP should be racking up some damage. I'm seeing a lot of surge protectors being knocked out. I'm also very thankful that our planes can take a good few hits from that flak. I forgot it was cooldown for a second. Oh, it's going down. That could be because of our EMP, if it's taking out batteries or engine. That could have been exactly what has happened. Or just control blocks. It's a bit hard to tell exactly what's been knocked out, honestly. But it looks like we are sending it into the water thanks to the EMP damage. Likely damage to engines. Oh, its weapons are no longer targeting. Except for that one. Or maybe I was just going mad and incorrect. By the way, it's now classed as too low. Not the most convincing victory, but a victory nonetheless. Well done planes for being tanks, well done the others for just bringing some EMP brain-breaking stuff. And AI dead. Okay, second enemy of 25, down it goes. What a beautiful enemy it was. We now have three of our little mech drones. Apparently the enemy had a friend. Oh, that EMP was beautiful. Look at that. Well done to our new vehicles. to the mechs, I suppose I should really call them, rather than new vehicles each time. One of them got taken out, which I think may have been friendly fire. That may have been friendly fire. It got in the way just as it fired. But this thing's now in the water, so pretty vulnerable. Okay, that EMP is obviously strong enough, at least in these difficulties. Since I've been mentioning overclocking a lot, let's just quickly talk about that. So essentially, particle cannons can charge anywhere between 1 to 30 seconds. This will increase the firepower drastically, as you can imagine, while also increasing how much energy you drain per shot. Overclocking will also increase the damage, but it will massively increase the energy per shot. As you can see, it goes from 5,000 to, let's say, 10,000 damage there in the bottom left, but the cost goes from 9,000, just about 10,000, all the way up to over 30,000, so three times the cost for only two times the damage. It's horribly inefficient in terms of how much damage you do for how much energy you use up. If you want a nice efficient and powerful particle cannon, it's gonna have to be a lot bigger. Now, that's pretty good for us because our mothership is feeding our drones. It means we can actually overclock them not too dangerously because we're constantly feeding it from a secondary source. But I can't afford that when I have so many of them. So I have now turned overclocking down to zero on all of our designs. So the EMP damage is going to be far less, but it's going to be way more efficient. Now we do have enough to make another one of these, but instead I think it's about time we start to retrofit them because I'm just not happy with the laser system. We could instead, since I don't want it to be too big, just add a small particle cannon. Now these are pretty expensive, but what you can do is just have them focus more on chambers than generators, which means they hold more charges but can't generate them very quickly, and then just fire once every 10-20 seconds with quite a large burst of plasma. That should be doing a lot more damage than the lasers. Because at the moment, this little laser system just isn't good enough. Though we could set it to be anti-munition. But we could just leave it until we have enough to make a whole new design and just make that one plasma. This is all the stuff I normally cut out of the video. In case you're ever wondering how it takes me 3 hours worth of recording for like 10 minutes worth of video or less, this is why. I can't decide things. I was busy making a new design and instantly we're under attack. Oh, instantly into the water as well. Well done, EMP. Yeah, we did not need that overclocking apparently. Now that's a proper looking mech. Hello there, the nostalgia. So in total, it's like 160k. Is hoping that EMP blasts can take out whatever's holding it. So if I can hit around here, that would be fantastic. Release the planes a little bit late, honestly. Probably should have sent them out earlier. Oh, they have short range small missiles. Not ideal. I've asked them all to target the base. It's already got it into the water. It was originally flying, I think. Air support's here. The air support seems to like it in the torso more, though, which isn't great, because it can be healed, but still. Oh. Oh, yep, there we go. Beautiful. Good teamwork, everyone. Meanwhile, I'm making a flying turret, which is just going to sit near the boat when I release them. Still a drone, I think, just not very maneuverable. Oh, I think the EMP did something, and that allowed the missiles to hit it. Okay, goodbye, flyer. Our turret's almost online. It should be here for the next fight. Until then, I have made a third one of our little bombard planes. Now, that's a big enemy, the Brigand. Thankfully, our plasma's online. As you can see, it just did 24,000 damage. Not sure where exactly it hit, but still. It's not exactly a strong turret, but now I have one, I can keep making them. Again, another 27,000 damage, and those are some nasty-looking missiles. Though, to be fair, they are mostly decoration, so I have no idea how big they actually are. Still, not so happy to see them coming in like this. That's it, keep going for the torso, not the base. That'll be great, thank you. Still happily firing away. Seems to have a lot of anti-air or perhaps anti-munition, it's hard to tell. I think we'll just turn that one turret off though. Yep, with a direct EMP shot. Fantastic. I Okay, down goes one of the mechs, that's fine. Oh, huge explosion, I'm sure. Oh, that's the plasma! Well done, the plasma! Massive chain reaction there. That flak is so good versus missiles. We could actually change one of the turrets into a defensive turret, which would just use a weapon like that. I do like flak. It's just fun to watch as well, just big ol' explosions, you know? Plasma just went through the gap it already made. Okay, not sure exactly which attack did that, but there we go, the enemy's down, we split it in half. I'd say that's a pretty good showing for the plasma. Where is the plasma turret, actually? Oh, there it is, where I left it. Because it doesn't move. Well, I guess it slowly floats around as its turret moves around, but still. Nice. Let's see if we can find a red portal. I'll avoid that resource zone even though I'm so tempted. Getting way too much resource this time around again, just because it's been so long building stuff. Ooh, look at you. Now that's how I should be building my drones. Though, maybe not just yet. They're 100 and... No, okay, you are 139,000. The smaller versions are still 46,000. Still a bit expensive for us, but still. Hopefully we can take them out. Okay, scored some EMP hits that time. Oh, they have particle cannons as well. Not nice to see. And an AI death from one of our particle cannons. One of them is already down. Is that the main one or one of the smaller ones? That's the main one. Well, that just completely broke them. Oh wow, that transform when they get close as well. It's actually a shame we didn't really get to see it. This one's already kind of flailing around. And particle cannon hits, and I think, yep, they were very, very vulnerable to EMP. A nice final fight in difficulty 13. Once again, the small minions proving their worth. Well, I was hoping the last one would be the final fight, but apparently one more thing really wants to defend this portal. The Alcazar. Okay, that's pretty big. I might just try and run for the portal here. This is going to take a long time to beat, and I don't really want to fight this thing. It also has a lot of point defense, if I'm remembering correctly, so likely these missiles won't actually hit it, which isn't great. I have no idea how resistant it is to EMP, though. Yep, there's the missiles being taken out by its laser system. Not ideal. Plasma damage is stacking up though, so that's going to be good. I am considering replacing the turret. As much as I really love the idea of a turret, the problem is the enemies are normally far too far away when they spawn in, and that isn't fun. A plane spawned in, got hit by a single EMP particle cannon, and was instantly out of the fight. Lovely. The Alcazar has hit a few of our planes now. One of them's gone down, one of them's damaged. Funnily enough, these quite cheap planes can't take a full cram shell to the face. Ooh, was hoping it wouldn't turn on me, honestly. I may recall everything to do some repairs and also get this turret a bit closer. Yeah, pulling it towards us now. Doesn't seem like EMP is really doing much versus the Alcazar. This is what I'm worried about. Larger enemies like this are very easy to protect versus EMP. Well, after a while, it does seem like we've pretty much won this. It has two cannons left online. The rest are all currently just offline. And most of the laser systems have been taken out. As you can see, the EMP is now burning through the innards. So the laser systems, the engines, everything else is currently falling out of the craft. So... Oh, looks like those guns may have been disabled now as well. Yep, the EMP, it took a while to work through it, but now the Alcazar is just a floating wreck. So just keep on going until it's dead and then some free harvest. Welcome to difficulty 35. Just built a second plasma turret with the earnings from that last fight, and this is our first enemy, which is... the Maelstrom. 200,000, wow. I always judge the cost of enemies wrong. Also, ignore the fact that one of the turret is currently flailing around horribly, it wasn't fully built yet when the fight started, and then instantly crashed into the side. Should be looking like that. Okay, so a lot of small missiles, they're probably going to hit the plane. No! These planes, weird... I was about to say, their weird ducking and diving means they get hit very infrequently, and then it instantly just smashes into the enemy. Doing almost no damage to the enemy, but destroying its own face. Definitely a thing. Well, with the headbutting plane aside, that went pretty well. Oh, well, that went down quickly to EMP. That is the agitation. It was spawning in some smaller drones as well. I can't wait until we have enough resources that our swarms are this size. Then I really want to try and make them look prettier than what we have at the moment. Not that I don't love all of you, my children. I just wish I had prettier children. Once again, Lathric should never be a father. It's a melee vehicle, I'm not entirely sure what it's trying to go for. Oh no, please keep going for it though, it does still have weapons. And it is right in the middle of all of us. It's worth almost 300,000 as well, so it's going to take a fair few hits to take this thing out. It's took out one of our planes so far. Oh, another enemy, this time Onyx Watch. Okay, this one's dead, AI dead, fantastic. Now, please,
engaging now.
Go for the Flying Castle of Death. Well, after these two fights, we can definitely build a new drone, which is great, since I want to make a new design. I'd like to make a proper aircraft, but like a hovercraft or airship. I want a weapons platform. It hasn't fired in a while, it hasn't fired its main weapons. I'm not sure if they're offline or damaged, or just it's not getting a good angle. Oh, no, there it goes, and let's start moving forwards. Hopefully we can just about make that, and... nope, direct it on us. Okay, I didn't think it was going for us for some reason. On the upside, it's getting closer to the plasma turret, so we are scoring more and more hits with the plasma. Those things are very cheap. I think it would be more effective if they were just larger. Oh, it's going to be able to bomb this one. Ouch. Okay, one of the turrets is still online if it can right itself. Good. Sacrificing the two turrets, we're going to be making an airship, which we'll be following in the same way that our little minions, our little mechs, are following us. Change my mind, we're making a cube. We have a cube. Now, it's actually not all that big, as you can see. Actually, it's kind of smaller than the planes, but it is significantly more expensive. It's about 60,000, so it's more than the plasma turret, less than the planes. It does have a much nastier particle cannon than the regular mechs, and it has four laser systems, which are basically copies from the mechs, because I didn't have enough time to rebuild everything from scratch. I think this thing's going to hit like a truck if it actually hits. But it won't be able to take many hits, so we're going to need multiple of them. But here's our little Borg cube, at least for the time being. Now we're just going to wait around for an enemy. I might start moving, but I do want my energy to come back first. This thing should be able to hit for 50,000, and it shoots twice with the particle cannon. It's using piercing, so it should go straight through the target. It should point at the enemy and move left and right, since it does have strafe capabilities. It's not well protected, though. If I had more resources, more layers of armor, and definitely a shield. This thing needs a shield in the front. It's gonna be pointing at things. I quite like it. I've never built a cube design. I don't know why I've never built a cube. Everyone builds cubes! Borg! Next hit, once again, going all the way through the target, and more of these cannons being knocked off. I haven't seen it fire back now in ages. It was definitely because of the cube. The cube has outshined every other drone. Trying to go for a red portal now so we can get to difficulty 40, and we missed. Oh, that's a shame. That'd have been so fun to hit. It's a much smaller target than the last one. Okay, so it has an advanced cannon, which is going after me. I was hoping it's going after the cube, apparently not. Oh, the EMP's done the job anyway. The last enemy now, before we go through the red portal. Okay, some anti-air, but it's not really doing too well against our blinds at the moment. Sadly, the first piercing shot from the cube missed. Oh, that one certainly didn't. That went right through it. And, yep, I think that's it. No, it's still going. Wow, that was a catastrophic explosion, but this thing still really wants to hit you in the face. I can appreciate something that explodes, but still wants to punch you. I mean, you've got to respect that. It's a level of attitude which everyone should strive for. Now, can you please fire again? Thank you. 31,000. Oh, that was it. Okay, that was the killing blow right there. Fantastic. Well done, my Red Borg. Oh, there's two enemies! For a second there, I thought the cube had gone a little bit mad and just fired into space. So I'm guessing that was the hit from the cube. Oh, that's beautiful. That's taken out a particle cannon with its first shot. So we have the Apollo here, which honestly looks terrifying because it looks like the Kobold, and the Kobold scares me. Ah, then we have a sub. The Umbra. I think the Apollo is probably scariest, honestly, especially since it looks like it's mostly torpedoes and most of that things fly.
Engaging now.
So please target the Apollo. Oh, I think it's cannon kind of misfire then because of the damage from our cannon. That's beautiful to see. What a nice start. We hit it so hard it hit itself. Yeah, the Apollo didn't last long after shooting itself in the face. Like most things. So instead we're going against this. So again, we do have sonars and everything on our Minecraft, so it is feeding that to all of our craft, so we should be able to see it alright. I've made it a little bit better as well. Okay, we just hit it with the piercing shot. Oh, are those going to be actual missiles? Oh dear, okay, we should have been focused on this earlier on, apparently. Okay, sadly though, we did mostly miss. Oh, EMP death! I mean, sorry, AI death. I wonder if that's from the EMP or the pierce weapon. I doubt it was the pierce weapon, honestly. Okay, well, two taken out pretty cleanly there. We now have two cubes. So twice the odds of actually hitting something important with those particle cannons every 30 seconds. Doesn't look like I got particularly lucky that time, though. And that thing is big. The Slasher. Okay, here's hoping we start hitting those turret caps, though. So far, it seems mostly focused on the planes. Not great. Also, I can only see two planes, which means I think it may have already taken one out instantly. Oh, no, no, never mind. It just wasn't currently in view. Don't know why that one's so far back, honestly. Okay, 77,000 damage there from the piercing weapons. So I'm guessing this is one of the shots. You can kind of see how they've lined up. Mostly just armor, though. I'm not seeing any vital components currently in the water, which is a real shame. They definitely went very far in by the looks of things, so just unlucky. Good, the cubes play well together. I've changed them up, so they definitely shouldn't be dodging in the same way. So during combat, they should get further and further away from each other over time. Not particularly quickly, but enough that they're never going to hit each other. Or, you know, just get in each other's way, generally. Oh, oh, that was a lot of damage again. This time, a very large explosion. Okay, one of the particle cannons took out this massive weapon. Well, it's not actually that massive, but I've been working on tiny drones for like the last 3 or 4 days. Everything looks huge to me now. I thought these cubes were massive, and I put them next to the planes, and I realized, oh no, never mind, they're titchy. They're just basically one weapon blobs. The laser's not really counting. still looks like, yeah, the piercing weapons have done great. They've taken out a lot of the weapon systems, if not all of them. Just this little one left, I think. Haven't seen it fire its missile, so... Well done, piercing weapons. You disabled this thing very quickly. Those lasers really are a joke at this point. Whee! Hopefully the last enemy of difficulty 40. The Panic. This thing also had two small drones with it, which instantly got taken out by the lasers. So fast, I didn't even get to see them, sadly. But that is the whole point of the lasers, to take out very, very small things like nuke drones and everything else. I have no idea what this thing's meant to do. It was hit by a lot of EMP very quickly, so there's a good chance things aren't working as they're meant to. Is it trying to get underwater? I'm assuming yes. Oh, that's a lot of vitals. Yeah, I think its particle cannons were taken out straight away, so... Love the look of the thing. Sadly, didn't really get a fair chance to fight back. We're about to hit a red portal, but this just happened. I don't think I've ever seen this. So one of the cubes just instantly struck this thing's AI. It didn't stand a chance. It got instantly knocked out. This isn't the crossbones, it's the smaller variant. How on earth did you knock out the AI of a crossbones? That must have been perfect. It must have been multiple hits all at the same spot. Either way, the crossbones just went down, and we're about to hit the red portal. I didn't even see the fight. Ow, 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 ow. Well, that was mean. You can take out crossbones in a few hits, but you can't take out this little thing. There we go. Okay. Apparently, our cube's now getting better at sniping targets. I'm gonna finish off converting this thing into a true hydrofoil, then we're going through the portal. Now we have some extra resource. I've decided, since this is going to take so long, and I really don't want to get into 100 fights before difficulty 45, just sitting there getting resources, I'm gonna do the redesign of the Minecraft here in the sandbox mode quickly, especially since this isn't actually gonna be used in combat, it's just there to carry around batteries, essentially. But I really do need to change it up. This thing was not built well at all. It was just a very rushed build. And what I was finding was trying to make it into a stable hydrofoil was just an absolute nightmare with how everything was really badly placed. So, major retrofit for the next few hours. So this is one of the least original designs I've had in a while. This is heavily inspired by the Reef Shark, which is from the Steel Striders. I think it's the Reef Shark, it's one of the sharks anyway. I'm purposely not spawning it in because I don't want to copy it one for one. Mine's a lot chunkier anyway, since my style is always very, very chunky, not exactly the most elegant. We're gonna have all the hydrofoils underneath here once I've rounded it off a bit more, and that's pretty much it. I believe the Reef Shark, or is it the Great White? Whichever one it is, also has their propellers on the bottom, and then all nice some decoration work, and that's how they stay above the water as well. I'm not entirely sure where we're going to be adding our propellers once this is done, but you kind of get the idea of what I'm going with. Well, definitely works. Need to make sure these are better protected, and then we can move on to the back section. With very little engine power, this thing's now going 65 meters per second, so just need it's a bit more balanced, and we're definitely getting this done right. Now, one thing I didn't know, and this is because I just never use these, is if we use the large rudders, which is what we're currently using as our hydrofoils, because I liked how they looked, these actually work in the air. You wouldn't think they do, but they do. When I set them way too high, as in I wanted to get to 500 meters just to make sure the thing's always above the water, we kind of took off, and continued to take off. Right now, we're having it so it just wants to be on the very, very surface of the water, and it touches it gently, and then continues to allow us to almost fly. That's fine by me. Now, if all the hydrofoils suddenly went, or the rudders, I guess in this case, which I'll be calling hydrofoils, we should still be able to move, because we're mostly made out of light alloy with loads of air gaps, so we are completely buoyant. Cool. The fact that this can work with the rudders may be one of the goofiest ways to fly. But it's stable and super easy to set up, which is just bizarre. Anyway, ignoring that, I'll set it back up in the water in a second. It's actually faster, thankfully, bouncing on the water than doing this, I guess, because so much drag is involved with this. I think I'm done for now. This is going to be the drone ship at the moment. It's mostly hollow, so it's not all that expensive, despite the size. Obviously, there's loads we can do decoration-wise and everything else. This is just as it stands at the moment. Well, the first enemy is just a small swarm. Amazingly, that managed to resist an EMP shot to the face. That's pretty impressive, honestly, for something that small. The lasers, though, are kind of made for this, so they won't be lasting too long. I've replaced one of the cube's top weapons with plasma, and the plasma is definitely doing better than the lasers do. Although there's way more laser weapons currently firing, the plasma has done half of the damage of all of those lasers combined. Definitely gonna stick with plasma from now on over lasers. This thing's taking a lot of hits. The Guernsey. Unless I just read that wrong, which is very potentially true. First enemy of difficulty 50, and I have no idea what this is. Well, that's just bloody cool. Look at you! Okay, this is how I need to try and build my mechs, apparently. The anguish.
Engaging now.
Try and go for the base if you can, lads. I'm imagining that base is going to be majorly EMP resistant. Okay, it does have anti-missiles, not really a surprise there. I think I dropped one of my cubes underwater. Yeah, I kind of released it when I was ducking and diving in the waves and released it underwater, so... Ooh! Trying to poke the plane, not quite working out. Okay, piercing shot did go through the target, didn't really do all that much. The missiles, on the other hand, are doing great. The enemy's laser system is damaged, though... I don't even know where the laser system is. What a cool design. If it went after my main craft or something else rather than the planes, which are just very hard to get close to, that would have been very, very scary. There it goes. Well, I fixed the cube. Oh, the fight's over. But the cube was fixed. What's all the melee craft at the moment? The Hunter. It avoided all of the piercing particle cannon shots. Oh, well, it didn't anymore. That's a lot of stuff that has fell off. I think that's one of its few ranged weapons. Oh, yep, the side just went. Who's it actually going for? One of the cubes or me? Might should reach me at this rate. I'm not gonna move though, I'm gonna believe in the power of the cubes! Please don't get in the way, cubes! Oh no, maybe I should move. You know what? I love your cubes, not believing in you anymore though. I should have just believed in them, now I feel bad. I need a new cube, and we should have enough resource to make a new one, actually, now. Wasn't quite ready for another fight just yet, so we do now have three cubes, at least. So that's a lot of plasma damage, as you can see that the plasma damage already going over 100,000 at this point. Oh, well, something just broke. Oh, AI dead, really? Man, those particle cannons are so nasty. The penetrating ones, that definitely isn't the EMP. We're actually one of the mechs down now. And only one of them's using EMP out of the two. After looking back at the footage, it seems like, honestly, it was the EMP which won, which is still shocking to me, since this is the entire weapon. Just these two little loops. They're very small particle cannons. Okay, this thing has some drones. Wow, it's very expensive.
Engaging now.
And the drone it's making is pretty big itself, honestly. Still, for now, please focus on the main ship. More likely to hit with the plasma, more likely to hit with everything, actually. Especially at this range. Okay, no missile defense, that's great. EMP keeps striking it, the plasma's already over 200,000, fantastic. Nothing vital being taken out just yet. It does have smoke defense. Where are the planes, though, the enemy drones? One of them has just ended up in the water for some reason, the other one is heading towards us. Whoa, it's pretty. Bombs. Are they bombs or anti... They're either anti-missile or they're bombs, I'm not too sure which. It does worry me though, because that's going to get very close to our main craft. But for now, I just want to take out the things with the big guns. Okay, has some anti-air weapons, I think it's flak. You can hardly see the plasma. That's my only problem with plasma. They move so fast and the orbs aren't too big unless you really stack them up. Okay, it's time to list. Is it going down? This thing can really take a lot of small caliber fire. Yep, that's definitely going in the water. Okay, that's pretty much that fight over then. So with that gone, yep, I think we're being attacked directly on our main vehicle.
Engaging now.
Oh, for neither bombs nor oof. Not too bad. Just loads of small missiles. This is why we keep some of the lasers around, although they don't do too much, as you can see, the damage is enough to start taking out small targets like this. Okay, another victory. I love my cubes. So, I think the mechs deserve a remake, honestly. They have been so much better than I expected when I first made them, and I was originally going to replace them with more cubes and planes and everything else, but I think it's about time I actually try my hand at making one of these properly. So, this is the new torso I'm building. This is all the decoration, the particle cannon inside. I wanted it to look at least somewhat pretty, and I want it to go the blue and green sort of colour scheme rather than the red and dark greys, which we've been doing before, and we are still sticking with EMP. It's going to be EMP till the end of the game now, because that was the whole theme of the original mech. So, I still want one arm to be locked in place, which is going to be the main particle cannon probably. Then in the other arm, I'm thinking either a railgun or more plasma, probably a railgun to add some difference to it. But then at the back, I want a couple of missile pods, which are going to be interceptors, so anti-missile missiles. Still don't want it to be too expensive though. The original torso was just shy of 20k. I want to try and stay under 60k for this. Not too happy with that, but work for now. Oh yeah, we're always going to be pointing at the target, aren't we? So this is actually on a turret, and the head should be turning towards the enemy. The problem is I'm always going to be facing them anyway, so it doesn't really matter too much. But you get the idea. Not too sure about this just yet. Maybe a little bit higher up, a bit more of a neck to it. Right now it's just kind of resting directly on the shoulders. Anyway, I'm going to just go way into the future after this clip, because I'm going to be messing around with this for several hours. I wanted these to be eyes, but yeah, that's as small as I can get. These look cool as like connections, though. These are just the melee cannon lens, and yeah, imagine that all over the thing. Don't know how I'd make that work, but I'm sure someone's done that at some point. So I've decided to go with a turret after all on the left-hand side. Now this design I am almost certain I've seen from a Twin Guard thing. I'm not sure if it was recently or an old one, I honestly can't remember, but I do remember a very large Twin Guard craft which had kind of like barrels hanging off like this. I think it had it for both arms. It may have been using advanced cannons, though. Not entirely sure which one. That's kind of the idea I have in my head from memory. So we have this all exposed, which I think I'm going to cover in glass, because we can make it look like ice as well, going with the blue and, very light blue theme. Messed around with some different types of eyes, not entirely sure if I'm happy. And I've gave it a halo, because giving things halos is actually very easy in this game. Now, because we're using a turret, we can use one of these long-range lenses, because we can aim it nice and easily. That way, we could have a much longer range, much nastier shot. And if we just swap this to EMP, yeah, we could do that, and then bring the pipes all the way back and have even maybe four shots. So four weakish EMP surges could easily take out things on turrets, is my thinking. Okay, now once again, skipping ahead in time. This took me like an hour and a half, by the way. Okay, quick test of the secondary weapon. So this is a 200mm railgun. So what this is shooting is just heat shells. That just killed it instantly. Okay, so proof of functionality there. So those shells are 200mm and they were heat shells. What that means is that they don't do much damage to the outside, but they send a stream of fragments through the target. Essentially, it's all about disabling sections. If it hits a turret cap, it can easily disable the connection points. If you get lucky like we did that first one, and apparently the second one as well, you can destroy its mainframe. One of these blocks, in fact that one right there, I think, was the mainframe, and instant death for the target. This is a fairly small railgun, it's only this section here. And that's it. That's our two weapons done. So we have a nasty EMP cannon, about four times as strong as the old version, and then we have a small railgun. All I need to do now is add some defenses, some smoke defense, and some anti-munition interceptor missiles, which I'll just be putting on the back over here. Have like an angled turret or something, which I think will look pretty nice. I quite like our little guardian mech. Okay, that works, fantastic. Now, I wanted a way more elaborate defense system, and maybe even some shields, honestly, but I've now officially run out of resources. We have just hit 61,000. My original goal was 60,000 for this craft. So for the time being, our little guardian angel craft is done. Now, I need to change up the base, because this thing no longer matches at all. I'm always impressed by how slow these planes get taken out of the sky. Sometimes you just make something good by accident. I think that's what these planes are. Saying that, if one of those shells hit the middle, then that's going to be a major problem. Oh, no, that EMP took out a jet. Never mind, it's going to be really rough movement from here on. There we go. Still took a good few hits, though. Well done, Angel. Let's not talk about the fact that I spent half an hour trying to design a robot spider. I don't know why I was doing that, I just kind of got distracted and then suddenly there's a robot spider in front of me. Anyway, back to building the base. Our first enemy with our new mech available. And instantly destroyed by our new higher strength EMP. Well, let's try and get to difficulty 60 then. That thing's already proved itself right away. Our first enemy of difficulty 60. And he had a pretty nasty welcome there. EMP and the piercing shots all hitting at once, and I think it's already broken. Oh, I know this thing. This thing almost killed me once. It looks almost innocent, but I'm fairly certain it has a really nasty drive-by. Yep, there's all the missiles. All hidden there under... Is it an actual opening, or is it just mimicry? I'm not too sure. But either way, yeah, that thing's missiles can be deadly, but it only releases them after going over you, and we seem to have broke it immediately. Oh, the heat cannon then, causing a massive internal explosion. I always knew particle cannons were good, but this run is really proving that, considering we still haven't got one big particle cannon. I might have to do a particle cannon-only run at some point to really learn the intricacies of the smaller versions, because I'm seeing little glimpses of it at the moment, and I am really impressed by them. Either way, this plane's obviously down, it can't fight back at this point. Okay, we're collecting way too many resources. A fight just happened over there, I don't even know what it was, because it was over before it really started. There's a blue portal there. What I'm going to do is upgrade the other mech into a second guardian, so we have two of these. I'm going to make my fourth cube, as is always the plan, and then we're going through the blue portal, catapulting us to difficulty 80, because I just feel like I've collected too much resource in this run. It wasn't intentional. I've stopped at no resource zones. It's just sometimes you get way more resource than you expect. Especially since I've been building and managing the fleet so much. I think I've been sitting around far, far too long. So here we are in the blue portal zone. In a moment, once everything's finished, we're going to go through the red portal, and that will take us to difficulty 80. So while I'm here, I'm going to be making one more guardian rather than one more cube. The reason is, right now, our main issue is power consumption. Everything I have, except for the planes, are taking a ridiculous amount of power. We have particle cannons, railguns, more particle cannons, lasers, we have plasma, which all just drain so much power. Now, so far, I've been using RTGs with two backup fuel engines, but that's hardly enough anymore. I'm constantly on the low end of my power, which is a real, real problem. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to retrofit this new guardian to not use energy weapons. So no railgun, no particle cannon. Most likely, it's going to use a large missile system, which is the big expensive one, which will have loads of health and take a lot of the brunt of anti-munition systems, since that's going to be able to take out our planes very easily. But then, I don't really know what else I'm going to use on the other weapon. Maybe a regular advanced cannon, some kind of rapid fire one. Not too sure. Or perhaps I could double down and make it a true missile guardian. And maybe have more anti-munition myself? Not too sure, probably gonna take me a few hours knowing me. Quickly in the sandbox mode to test out a couple of missile systems. So first of all, we have these medium missiles with the thumper heads and reinforced bodies, which means they're really hard to shoot down. They also have the laser designators. They're targeting using these lasers here, which means they can't be distracted by any decoys. Then we have the larger missiles using remote guidance, which I very rarely use. And then these also have some extra reinforced bodies in addition to the thumper heads themselves, which means, again, they're quite hard to shoot down, but should have enough payload to make them worth it. These ones probably won't hit for much, but are going to be so annoying to stop. The idea is, not as much damage as usual, but way more consistent damage and very hard to actually prevent. So first of all, the kinetic shells. Okay, they broke something. They all hit this spot here and have almost fully disabled this turret. Then the larger missiles, and they have just completely removed one of the guns and done damage pretty much everywhere because fragments are fragments. That's perfect. It's not a shocking amount of damage, it's not gonna be able to take down big things by itself, but this is just one of the guardians, we're gonna have multiple of them. That's perfect. I don't want to do too many tests versus actual munition defense though, because then it'll be a bit too telling. Though that was fantastic. So one of the big benefits to the laser designator is that all the missiles hit the same spot, which means they go through the target. Yeah, that's great. Between them, I think this is actually going to be a really nasty thing to fight against. I do think it's going to struggle, though, with very fast-moving targets, just because of how the laser designator and the remote guidance work. But we'll see that once we get back into the game. Okay, I am happy enough with that. First enemy of difficulty 80. Okay, this thing's worth 603,000, a little bit less than I expected, actually, looking at it, but still. Okay, missiles did just strike, both the physical and the fragments, which I guess is also physical, still hit. Oh no, those are the ones from the Guardian, never mind, look at that! Just devastated that midsection. The kinetic ones hit, then the fragments hit straight after, this entire section just went bye-bye. Well, the new Guardian just proved itself. I was getting mixed up with our planes missiles there for a second, so yeah, that was a very easy first fight. I'll ring the adventure bell as soon as I can. Oh. Didn't expect space. Well, that's going to be useless for our missiles. Very unlikely we're going to hit these things this far away. Oh, we broke something off it straight away, though. Oh my god, that's missiles from the enemy. That's horrifying. The Archangel. Oh my god, it's just missiles! Did we do that? What killed that? Speaking of angels, guardian angels, any chance you might have enough anti-missile... I do not get what happened to that thing's missiles. I do not get what I did. Maybe I broke their missile system so it hit itself? What a weird couple of first fights. Oh, it's all over there, okay. I'm gonna assume lasers. Why are they stopping so quickly? Okay, this thing's firing missiles, never mind. What did we do? What did we hit? Why are they turning off so quickly? I mean, I'm happy with my attacks doing this, but what is doing it? Is it the heat shells? I don't think it was the particle cannons. They missed. The cubes missed. I doubt it's the EMP at this difficulty. Well, I definitely have enough now for the fourth cube, or a fourth guardian. One of the two. I looked back at the footage. It was 100% the particle cannons. Well, after those weird fights, four cubes, two missile guardians, two energy guardians, and three bombards. I'm gonna find a red portal. I guess I'll make one more drone type before the end, but we're getting very close now to the end, honestly. Turns out particle cannons have been incredibly effective, and I am really impressed by those new missile types, which I never use for some reason. We have the Basking Shark. This is a 1.2 million resource craft with some nasty missiles, so I'm hoping that some of our own missiles and particle cannons and everything else can take off these missile systems before they can fire. Would be ideal. So far it isn't firing, so guess it has a maximum range? Oh, there we go. There they are. Those look horrific. I really doubt its anti-missiles are going to be able to take that out, to be completely honest, but at least they weakened it a little bit. Oh my god, yeah, those missiles are absolutely deadly. Who would have thought the 1.2 million craft, which is focused on missiles, can actually have good missiles? Mag-Zaz look like throwing balloons at something. Let's keep going. Our plasma damage now is over 500,000, which is pretty impressive. Yay for the cubes. Oh, we're like shearing it in half. I'm seeing a lot of heat shells hitting as well, so I'm hoping they're doing some internal damage. I haven't seen the other missiles fire, so I'm assuming we broke some of the systems. It really should have fired more missiles than that. Stop proving me wrong! Something target this. I'm assuming this is where the AI is. I'm seeing a lot of EMP protection and everything else, so probably something vital there. Might want to hit it. Brilliant, there we go. Perfect. That's going to be a lot of resource, though saying that, that's going to be very expensive to repair. Actually, no, the base got obliterated, sadly, but the torso itself seems fine. What I need to do is start attaching some repair tentacles to the torsos, that way when they get knocked off like this, they can actually start helping the repair effort. I can't talk at the moment, it's now 1 AM and apparently my speech has gone somewhere else. Everyone's just dodging missiles today, apparently, from both sides. Whoa! That was nasty. Well, it shows how much of these bases have been upgraded, the fact that didn't go down. The old one would have simply vanished after that. We have our first enemy of difficulty 85. Are they lasers, or... Oh! I know you, and those are massive. Okay, this thing's missiles are ridiculous, the monsoon. But they're not the most well protected, so some good hits on the side there could take out a couple of them before it fires. It's not currently in range to aim, apparently, so just keep going. I've changed the EMP on our Guardians, so now they're firing every 30 seconds rather than every 10, but with a much stronger yield. Since in the last few fights, I don't think the EMP is really carrying its weight. Yeah, that time I saw some vitals fall from the EMP, but looks like our own missiles have stopped it from attacking. Oh, it's just about got the weapons going, and they missed. Wow, its anti-missile systems are actually pretty good. I thought they were pretty bad, but nope, I was completely wrong until our missiles hit. Every time I say anything, I'm instantly proven wrong. I should just start saying things bad for us, and then suddenly we'll be gods. Look how much EMP that is now. Fantastic. Yeah, this poor thing got shredded. So quickly, so many vitals just went bye-bye. I have seen the damage this thing can do, though. Those missiles are the size up from the ones we're using. So just for reference, the missiles we're using are the large ones. They're using the huge ones. So each of those missiles, I think, are these, which is kind of ridiculous. That's just the launcher for them. Perfect. Keep it in the back of this thing. That's gotta be its vulnerable section, right? Also, I've only just clicked. The reason why some of my missiles are so inaccurate is that laser designators are affected by smoke. So any smoke defense which stops normal lasers will also stop our missiles from targeting correctly. Like when it's yellow like this rather than green, it means it's only a weak lock. If it's red, it's not really a lock at all. Okay, looks like it took out its particle cannon. That's fantastic. That's its main weapon in its core. And in the time it took us to kill it from its vulnerable section, it managed to take out the other craft. I've never been so happy to see a double spawn before. We must have taken out its engine. It just sank. Oh no, there it's jets. Okay, the jets are taken out. My stamina is getting worse and worse. I need to get some sleep. This will be the last fight before I go to sleep finally. Lovely. So after last night's recording session, I decided just to spend a half an hour just messing around the sandbox mode, different designs, and I think this is what we're going to go with next. It's going to be replacing the bombard. So rather than having a whole new drone, we're going to be replacing our bomber planes. This time, I want it to be a bit bigger and definitely a bit sturdier. Though to be fair, those planes weirdly take a lot of hits to take out, so hopefully this thing will have enough redundancy to have the same kind of vibe. So this is very strongly based off the Steel Striders. I know there's at least one plane with a very similar style, especially since I'm going to be building a double tail to this thing, which again is very Steel Striders. And I'm not entirely sure of the weapons. I'm very tempted to be a little bit silly. And yes, once again, particle cannons. I know I've been using them a lot this run, but I think it'd be fun to have a couple of vertical particle cannons in these little bit on the wings. Something like that. Just absolutely tiny, as small as the original Guardians were, and just with EMP or something like that. That way it can shoot down other planes and just do a little bit of fun damage. I also think it would look kind of cool. It will be vulnerable though, so these things will be absolutely tiny. They're more just secondary weapons. The main weapon is likely to remain missiles. Though I could also add a very small railgun or advanced cannon as well. Yeah, that's definitely good enough. So the little particle cannons really do very little damage because I don't want to use up too much power. Most of this thing's thrust as well is just the custom jet in the middle, which means, again, not using up power. So the bombard won't be increasing our power consumption by much at all. All I need to do now is decorate it and change its movement a little bit. I want it to do some more roll-based turns a little bit to make it a bit harder to hit. Other than that, I think it's good to go. Bit more firepower than I had before, way more armor, looks better in my opinion. And we're gonna have three of them. Just added a couple of anti-missiles to the new bombard, let's see if they actually work. Yes they do, fantastic. There we go, enough damage to force the old one into a tailspin. And took out its attack. Perfect. Good. Nice and simple. Now, we could add shields to this. I did add some really basic shields to the Guardians, but again, it's just energy consumption is the main problem. The second we enter difficulty 90, instantly under attack by a Sovereign. He's facing the wrong way to begin with, which was really nice for us. That's actually very rare to see. Our planes are heading towards it, which is great, though I think one of them may have got taken out immediately. I can only see two of them, unless I'm going crazy, which wouldn't be too much of a shock. Where is the third one? I had three, I don't know where the third one's gone. Oh, it's over here because I shot it backwards. Okay, so apparently these have a bit of a tougher time turning around when they're first released in comparison to their old versions. Still, they're happily firing away with their particle cannons. Should have released their missiles by now, so I'm assuming they got taken out because I didn't see any missile hits. Yeah, if nothing else, it will be using up the enemy's power because they all have reinforced bodies, they all have some extra health. Though the Sovereign, apparently, in its 1.4 million glory, has a lot of munition defense to spare. Yeah, none of them are even getting close. Here's the larger missiles from one of our Guardians. I'm hoping, because it's been using up so much power on all of our smaller missiles, maybe it couldn't defend against them as well? I think we took out its main weapon, it's just not firing. I don't know when, I don't know what attack got it. Maybe it was one of the EMP surges to begin with, maybe it was one of the many particle cannon shots, but that main cannon is not firing back. At the moment, it's just defending itself and nothing else. I didn't even get to see that happen because all of the cubes hit straight away like they always do. Okay, the planes are playing nice, so that's great to see. The Sovereign has been stripped of most of its outer armor at this point. And it seems like its laser systems are also badly damaged. A lot more missiles are actually getting through, at least on the left-hand side. Yeah, the new version of the bombards are so much better. Their missiles are better, being able to destroy the enemy distraction sticks were great, and their particle cannons, though weak, just provided such a nice bit of consistent damage, just taking off chunks of the enemy at a time. Goodbye. That looks like Scarlet Dawn again. Trying to get some revenge for its fallen comrade. Okay, it has a lot of anti-missiles, that's fine. Once again, I'm hoping our new versions of the bombards can drain some of that power before the larger missiles get there. Don't know how those missed, though, just then. Okay, these have a lot more health. Lovely. Oh dear. Well, at least we have more anti-missiles on our side now, but I doubt they're going to stop all of these. Yeah, a little bit of damage done to them, but those are definitely going to hit our main vehicle. ...10% of the drone carrier's health lost instantly there. Oh, but it seems like the target's going down, though. Yeah, being in the middle of all of our drones is a bit much. Oh, AI death, in fact. Lovely. Well, another satellite. So right now I'm just after a red portal again, and I'm currently making a fourth bombard. So we have four of each of the drone types going into difficulty 95. All it takes is one of these plasma to get a little bit too far, and that gun's gone. It's... Oh well, I'm already seeing bits of a railgun being removed, so I'm assuming its gun is damaged? No, it is definitely firing. The shells are just moving very, very quick, so it's hard to tell sometimes. Stop firing at me! Fire at a drone! I can heal a drone! At least not moving by default, honestly. Well, the satellite's still there, but now we also have the Great White to deal with, so a very large steel strider craft. I'm just hoping we damage the satellite enough that it's no longer a major threat. Are those cram shells, or are those... Oh god, they are cram shells. Going after a plane, so I hope that's a miss then. Great for us, the first target is something which cram is not necessarily great at. Just about dodging, jeez. How much anti-missile stuff does this thing have? Oh, it looks like there's a chance the satellite is also targeting the Great White. Fantastic. The Great White's just too much of a juicy target being so big. So we're also getting a railgun from space helping us. You can always tell when the larger missiles from the Guardians hit because they absolutely rip sections off the enemy. In fact, I think the enemy's already been disabled. That's kind of ridiculous. We're just very good at turning things off on the enemy, not necessarily doing huge chunks of damage. So if anything could change target back to the space gun, that'd be great. Oh, I saw some explosions and I think that was a bit of the railgun just going bye-bye. Yeah, the Great White's been completely disabled. Between us and the, I'm assuming some kind of piercing shell? Didn't really stand a chance of being online for too long. Looks weird from down here, can you just about see it? Kind of makes me think of the Hyperion H from Borderlands. Which is a game I've not played in a very long time. I think that's it. Its gun is no longer firing, so it is now completely defenseless. Now can I please find a red portal? Well, difficulty 95, and apparently nothing wants to fight us, so with our 4 bombards, our 4 cubes, our 4 guardians, and a single one of ourselves, I guess it's time for difficulty 100. I'm fairly confident we're going to be okay, and I've got to be honest already before we get to the end where I kind of dissect this run. I think if I ever did this type of run again, I would probably ban particle cannons. I ended up relying on them too much, though they are so much fun. I really underestimated the power of smaller particle cannons, that was the big thing, so I thought it wouldn't be too bad if I used loads of them, and my god, the power level! Tell me if you agree in the comments. I also now am desperate to do a missile-only run, because there's loads of different types of missiles that I don't normally use, like the pure kinetic ones, and I think they could be so much fun. So, yeah, tell me in the comments what one you want to see next, because win or lose, difficulty 100 awaits. And in difficulty 100, we've used the adventure bell straight away, so our first enemy here will arrive. As long as we beat one enemy in difficulty 100, I will consider this a successful run. Ooh. Oh, I know those weird blue dots. That is... I can't remember the name of it, but I know it's white flyers. So I do know what it is, kind of. I know it has particle cannons and railguns. The Redeemer. I don't know about its anti-munition capability, though. I actually have no idea about that. Here's hoping not much, but I very much doubt that, to be honest. Is hoping our own particle cannons will quickly take out its particle cannons, or at very least railguns, much larger targets. Okay, it has anti-munition in the form of lasers. And missiles. Okay, so it's going to be stopping a lot of our missiles. Those were the kinetic rounds, the ones with all the extra health, and they got stopped almost instantly. Thankfully, the target is slow enough that we are consistently hitting with our heat shells at least, so some internal damage potentially. Okay, EMP struck the enemy a few times. Our plasma damage is adding up. Okay, so it's firing at our planes. That one's been hit by a particle cannon several times. Ooh, now it's been hit by the railguns as well. Still flying though, so I'm happy enough with that. Well done, that plane. Just keep on distracting the enemies and I'll be very happy. Our lack of just basic damage, ooh, is definitely showing. So, okay, one gun down. Ah, none of the missiles are getting through. And its particle cannons are really chewing up our planes. That one has finally gone down. Oh, we got so close to the enemy. They should be fairly EMP resistant, so realistically these should still be, yep, still activated, still firing. Not that our missiles can actually get to this thing, mind you. Still happy with the blinds, though. They're taking a beating and still just going, so... yay for me being happy with one of my designs. Yeah, the heat shells are hitting repeatedly. Here's hoping they're doing something to the internals. Take out its engines, its battery storage for its railguns, its laser systems just... ooh, speaking about laser systems, our missiles are now getting through. What happened there, then? Are those all battle cannons? Yeesh. Ooh, chain reaction, a gun just went down. Wonderful. Our missiles are now more reliably hitting as well. I think we might clutch this. Yeah, with the missiles now going through like that, we're actually doing proper damage in addition to all of the stuff trying to disable the target. I think at least one of the turrets was taken out by a parcel cannon, one of them with one of the heat shells from one of the Blue Guardians. I don't think it's fighting back anymore, except for a self-defense weapon. No, it does still have some regular missiles, never mind. But in comparison to what it had, that is very, very little. We have our first victory, I think. Oh, one of our planes ended up in the water. Well done, though. Very proud of you. Very proud of you, little bombards. It took like another 3 minutes. With one more plane apparently finally going down, but there we are. So two of the planes were taken out of the sky. Other than that, everything else was still going near the end. Lovely. Oh, I vaguely recall you, and you're facing the wrong way, which is great for us. We have the Pyre.
Engaging now.
Very similar to the Extinction. Oh, look at the design of that. That is so freaking cool. Seriously, that is just amazing looking. Took out some of its detection systems there, which is good. In case you're wondering, with our detection systems, although the bulk of it is still on the main craft, I do have quite a lot of it hidden on pretty much every drone. All of the Guardians have their own detection systems, which they do feed into everyone else, and the Bombards have some really basic stuff as well. But I hate how it looks, so most of it is in with Mimics. What happened to those first little drones it had? Were those nukes, or...? Yeah, I'm assuming that's a nuke. And it's making another one as well. I don't know if I should try and get my stuff to go for that, or just keep on piling the pressure on the Minecraft. It's going for me. It's going for the main vehicle. Okay, we need to start moving. Keep on firing. If it goes into the middle of everything, that's really bad for it, because suddenly it's going to be hit all over. That does mean we won't get, whoa, concentrated fire on a section, which isn't great, but it also means if it has any vulnerable sections or sections not quite as sturdy as that front, it's going to start being hit. Another nuke was being spawned and stopped. That's going really high up now. Is that intentional, or is that something breaking? It's difficult to tell sometimes. Nope, that's classed as too high. That's definitely not intentional. It's also not turning anymore. We've broken its movements. I'm guessing the back section here would have housed most of its out thrusters. Let's have a quick look-see. Yep, two thrusters there. There's a thrust there which has been damaged, I think, and I'm assuming some of these have also taken quite a few hits. By rushing past all the drones, it's just left its movement really vulnerable. Wonder how much the EMP is doing as well. I have changed some of the Bombard missiles to be EMP as well, just for a bit of fun. So unless the enemy is well protected everywhere, the EMP could be causing some problems. It's still airborne, impressively, despite all the damage it's taken. But as long as it's facing sideways, not all of its guns can be brought to bear. Oh, come on, plasma or something. Hit those turret caps. Just take out the barrels. That is sinking so quickly. Oh, will it touch the water and get sunk? Nope, doesn't look like it. Haven't seen much munition defense though, so most of the missiles are getting through. At least they are now, but I honestly didn't see much even to begin with. Especially in comparison to the last enemy. Not saying that some of the missiles did get stopped then. We've ran all the way over there at this point. How is it still airborne? Oh my god, it's just made out of armor, and more armor. Oh, that's not great. The drone carrier's been badly damaged. Lots of its batteries have gone, lots of its RTGs as well. Just gonna sitting here for the last minute as this thing sinks and eventually dies. Hopefully it's enough resource for another repair, but that one did a number on us. The first fight we gained resource, this one, I'll be happy if we just survive. And keep all the drones, I don't have to sacrifice any. I didn't have a chance to heal another enemy. Red portal right there though, if we can just limp to that portal. Then it'll despawn this enemy. Oh, but every shot is costing us. Oh, I've been able to, recall the planes. How nice. Ah, this is it. Even if we do make it, I don't see us surviving another fight afterwards. We managed to get to the red portal. We are returning to where all of our other drones are. We're still repairing our main vehicle in addition to everything else. I may have to sacrifice a cube or something. The cubes are worth around about 80,000 each or so. So if one of those are destroyed and the resource distributed, that'd be quite good. Although, oh brilliant, there's a resource zone next to a red portal. We can sit at the resource zone, gather all this resource. If an enemy appears, we just jump to that red portal. Okay. I just want to get one more kill. Let's see if we can repair after that last fight and get one more kill. We have what is going to be the last fight, probably, of difficulty 100, and it is Scarlet Dawn. It is the Gorse, or Gauss. I never know how to pronounce that. Anyway, lots of guns. Let's release all of our drones and let's see how this goes. Thankfully, I didn't have to sacrifice any of my drones. I did have to sacrifice some of the internal RTGs and a few other things on the main craft. But that's it. Considering this is some of the last fights, that's fine. Okay, so is that laser system anti-missile? Yes, it is. Thankfully, the kinetic shells... Ooh, were actually really good there. Oh, not quite hitting where I thought they were hitting. I thought they were hitting that turret cap. It looks like they just missed it. Still, that'll be a lot of its laser system drained, trying to take out those. Since those are the kinetic shots from one of the Guardians. Oh, those missiles are going to completely obliterate our Guardian. Sure, it fired its anti-missiles, but yeah, it's far too much. Okay, our EMP missiles just hit. Fantastic. Missiles from our planes are just now reaching the target, and it couldn't stop any of them. Oh, that is nasty. Really large advance cannons there shooting down the plane. Still, most of our craft are fighting on. The cubes are still firing their plasma, which is great, because that's good at chunking off armor sections. More of the planes missiles, and quite a few of them hit. Lots of EMP damage, not sure if it actually took out anything important, but still nice to see. A jet just got removed. Okay, a few of those missiles went underneath, which is exactly where I wanted them. The planes are kind of chasing the enemy off, because it's trying to stay a certain distance from the closest enemy, which of course is the planes. Oh! That just obliterated one of the planes. Still three in the air, though, so I'm okay with that. Just keep on going. You've got to cut through that front armor eventually. I mean, look at how many blocks are being taken off. It is definitely designed to be fought from the front, though, so it is surviving a lot. It just can't take out all these missiles. Even the planes missiles do have reinforced bodies, so they have increased health at the cost of some of their damage. See, I said that, and I don't think any of those missiles actually hit. Never mind. Oh, probably just timed it well with their interceptors. The heat shells are definitely hitting a lot as well. I'm just seeing so many little components, and a lot of it isn't armor, so it is taking off stuff. And occasionally, things. Yep, this is the commentary you tune in for. I think this will be a victory, though. Saying that, I can't even see the cubes are so far away. We're kind of pushing them... Yeah, we're kind of pushing it too far away. It's making it difficult for the cubes to get direct hits. I wonder how much of this thing is armor, because that whole front section must just be pure armor at this point. That took so long. I actually had to recall the planes to force it to get closer again. This thing is a marvel of just sheer armor defense. Okay, going straight after the main vehicle, not really a shock there, honestly. That's actually quite bad, because it will take out the power for all of the drones. And those shots are ridiculously strong. Oh, the cube there taking a few hits for its mother. How sweet. Seeing a lot of blocks falling off the event horizon, though. If we can take out that turret, it's over very, very quickly. It's all in that one super weapon it has. Already down, well, half of our battery power is already gone. And, oh, almost hitting us then in melee, which, oh, something just happened. I think that was the cube. I think without a doubt, that was the cube. Oh yeah, this whole section's been damaged already. And I think it may have just got the very, very underside of the turret cap. Well, not the turret cap, the actual turret itself. And yep, that's it gone. I think I might need to ban particle cannons next time. Because again, these aren't even particularly massive particle cannons. Wow. I suppose that is something that the Event Horizon is vulnerable to, though. It has one major weak spot, which is also its super weapon. Well, with that, I'm going to be calling the episode here. I really do hope you've enjoyed. This is likely going to be 1 or 2 weeks late from when I originally wanted to upload it due to a whole manner of things in real life, along with this video being by far the longest video in terms of recording time I have ever produced on this channel. It took so many weeks. So I really do hope you enjoy. This was just an utter pleasure to record. So, so much fun. Tell me any suggestions for future challenge runs you'd like to see, and how much are particle cannons just game-breaking? With our lovely Star Eater cubes. Thank you for watching, have a lovely day, and do take care, and until next time, remember, having friends is the real strength. Sideways friends for bonus points.